Hello everyone, today I am going to show you the various parts of a high flow nasal oxygen machine and how to operate it. Coming to the various parts, this is your power cord that provides power to this machine. This is to be connected to the oxygen port. This is your flow meter that shows the amount of oxygen liter per minute. This is the connector from the flow meter to the machine. Now this machine, this is a humidifier and also the flow generator. This is a water channel and this is a connector that connects the water chamber to the humidifier. This is an air piece that collects gas flow from the humidifier and delivers it to the patient. Now here we connect the patient interface. It can be an adult interface or the pediatric interface. Now coming to the mechanism, the gas flow is delivered from the oxygen pipeline here to the flow meter. The oxygen passes through this blue tube to the humidifier. From this port, the oxygen is delivered to the water chamber. Here, the gas flow gets humidified and it gets heated up to a desired temperature because of this silver plate over here. This plate heats the water present in this water chamber. Now, this is the connector that is to be connected this way. This has to be pressed down. Here there is a groove through which this has to be slid. This is slid so that it fits here and you should get a click sound. Now we know this is perfectly fitted. Now this is the connector that is connected to a water bag. The water from the water bag goes into this water chamber and is filled automatically up to this black bar. If the water goes above this black bar, we need to change the water chamber. This air piece has an inline heated wire all throughout. This ensures that the temperature and the humidity of the air flow or the gas flow to the patient is maintained. There is another sensor over here at the end that again ensures that the temperature and the humidity of the gas flow delivered to the patient is as set in this monitor. So this is our water bag. This consists of distilled water. We have replaced the NS with distilled water. This is the connector as any IV set. This is hung over here. The air chamber, it is opened up. This has to be kept open. Now this is our panel. This is a screen, display screen. This is the power button. This is the alarm mute button. This is the mode button. These are the two buttons to increase or decrease the values that has to be set. To switch on the machine, we need to press the power button for 5 seconds. So this is the machine starting up. Here the latest disinfection was shown. We should not operate this machine if the orange light was displayed, as in here. That means the machine has not been disinfected properly. If the machine has been properly disinfected,
the green button which was below, that will glow. That means the machine is ready to use. So here we can see three parameters displayed: 28 degrees Celsius the temperature, 50 liter per minute the flow, and the FiO2 21%. Now we can change the first two parameters, the temperature and the flow, by using the mode button. So once we use the mode button for one time, the temperature set comes up. Now we can see that the setting of temperature is locked. To make a change in the temperature that has to be set, we need to long press both the buttons, the up and down button together, for about 3 seconds. Now we see that it is blinking. Now we can change. Now we have a range 31 degree to 37 degree Celsius. So we can either make it to the body temperature 37 degree Celsius, or if the patient complains that the air is too warm for him or her, we can reduce the temperature to 31 degree Celsius. Once you have selected the temperature, again press the mode button. Now again this gets locked. So the temperature is set at 31 degree Celsius. Now again if you press the mode button, we come to the flow. Now again we can change the flow by again long pressing the up and down button for 3 seconds. So the flow liter per minute is now blinking. That means this is ready to be changed. The limits is 10 liter per minute to 60 liter per minute. We can set as we feel necessary. After 30, the unit reduces to 1. After setting the flow, if you again press the mode button, we reach to the FiO2. FiO2 has a limit of 21 to 90%. This FiO2 cannot be changed by pressing the up or down button. For changing the FiO2, you need to change the oxygen flow from the flow meter. Depending on the flow set, as you change the oxygen flow, so accordingly the FiO2 will change. So you turn this knob accordingly and set the FiO2 as per your necessity. Suppose here the flow set is 50 liter per minute, you need to provide a flow of 50 liter per minute from the flow meter to make it a FiO2 of 100%. Similarly, if you reduce the oxygen flow from the flow meter, depending on the flow provided here, the FiO2 will change. So to change the FiO2, you need to change the flow from the flow meter, and you change it till you achieve your desired FiO2 here. So the oxygen from flow meter goes into the humidifier. From humidifier through this port, oxygen comes into the water chamber. From water chamber, the airflow goes into back into the humidifier and then to the patient through this airpiece. The airpiece has an inline heated wire all throughout the length that maintains the temperature and humidity of the airflow. This prevents the condensation of water vapor in this tube. And this is the sensor at the patient end that again ensures that the humidity and the temperature of the airflow is maintained. So this is the patient interface. This is one adult nasal cannula. This is a nasal cannula, nasal port that goes into the nostrils. This is an adjustable strap that has to be tied around the head. This strap should not touch the ears while tying. This has to be connected to this. Again, another clicking sound confirms proper fitting. Now for going into the pediatric mode, long press the mode button. This is the junior mode or the pediatric mode. Now this restricts the temperature and the airflow to a certain limit. As we can see, if you press the mode button, we first go into the temperature. We see that only 34 degrees Celsius is allowed in the junior mode. When we go into the flow, because of the junior mode, a maximum of 25 liter per minute is allowed and the minimum of 2 liter per minute. So this machine overall can produce a flow of 2 liters to 60 liter per minute.
When you are disconnecting the machine from the patient, we first switch off the oxygen and then switch off the machine. Do not keep oxygen running when the machine is idle or not being used. So first the oxygen has to be stopped, then the machine has to be switched off.